Hello everybody. The result that is reflection properties. Reflection. Reflection properties. Reflection properties, particularly for hyperbola. For hyperbola. After this one, I shall discuss also the reflection property for parabola. So let's draw a picture of hyperbola. Suppose. Let us draw their axis first. These are two axes. Suppose this is one branch of hyperbola and this is another branch of hyperbola. And in case of hyperbola, these two points are the foci. This is one focus and this might be the another second focus, say S prime. We know that their coordinates are AE comma 0 and this one would be minus AE comma 0. So these are the coordinates of these two focus, S and S prime. Now, so this might be the position. Let us draw by some other color. Suppose this might be the position of the directrices. This is one directrix, and this is the second directrix. And we know that in case of hyperbola, the equation of the directrices are x is equal to a by e, and the second one is x is equal to minus a by e. These are the equations of these two directrices. This is first directrix and this one is the second directrix. Now if you consider any point P, this kind of point, whether let us choose it over here. This kind of point P, this is the point P having coordinates x1 comma y1. And what is the equation of the hyperbola? We suppose that the equation of the hyperbola is x square by a square minus y square by b square. This is minus is equal to 1. This is the equation of the hyperbola. Now, I told you the definition of conic in the last lecture. As per that definition, we had to draw the perpendicular distance from P on this kind of directrix, it's PM, and this is the distance PS. I told you that PS by PM, PS by PM, if this is a constant quantity, suppose E, in that case, and if this particularly, if this E is greater than 1, in that case, we say that P traverses a hyperbola, or the locus of the point P is the hyperbola. So over here, this E, the eccentricity of the hyperbola, is greater than 1. Okay, and in the case of the second directrix as well, suppose this is the perpendicular distance from second directrix. Suppose this is the base of the perpendicular M prime. We shall first prove an inequality over here. But before proving that result, let us first state what is actually the reflection property. The reflection property is that now over here at the point P, if you consider a normal line, in this case, in case of hyperbola, in case of ellipse, we consider a tangent line. But over here, in case of hyperbola, we shall have to consider a normal line. Say this kind of normal line. Say this is a normal line. And along this kind of normal line, if you have a mirror, if you have a mirror along this kind of normal line, in that case, the any ray emitting from this focus S towards the point capital P, that will after reflection, it says that will after reflection pass through this second focus S prime. That means we shall have to show that this is the reflection of the ray after reflecting at a mirror situated along the normal to the point P. Okay, so we should have to show that this PS prime is the reflection of the ray PS. And how to show this result? How to show this result? Over here, we can draw a tangent line over here. We can draw a tangent line like this. Maybe this is the tangent line at the point P. And suppose this point, this is the base of the tangent line. Let us call it the point N. Okay. This is the origin O. Okay. And we shall have to firstly show the result that S prime N, just exactly same result as we put in case of ellipse. S prime N divided by SN. That becomes is equal to P S prime divided by P S. We shall have to show this result. How can we show this result? Let us first consider this idea of eccentricity. I told you that P S by PN, let us write it over here. I told you PS by PM. PS by PM is equal to the eccentricity E, and therefore from this result we can say that PS is equal to E into PM. Alright. And what is the distance PM? PM is actually this much distance. ES is equal to the distance, perpendicular distance of the point P from this first directrix. X is equal to A by E. Now, what is that perpendicular distance? This perpendicular distance, if we consider a perpendicular line over here, suppose this is the point, say the point Q. Okay. In that case, you see this PM distance, that must be is equal to this U. And suppose this is this point, this is the point of intersection of the directrix and the x-axis. This is suppose our M1. So QM1. All right. And this QM1 should be written as OQ minus OM1. Now, what is OQ? OQ is actually this this much distance OQ, this much distance OQ, that should be actually the x coordinate of the point P. This much distance OQ, because this is the perpendicular distance, this is the perpendicular, PQ is actually the perpendicular. Therefore, over here we can say that this OQ is actually is equal to the distance x1. And what is this OM? OM1? OM1 is the distance of the directrix from the origin. And what is the distance of the directrix from the origin? This distance is equal to A by P. As per the equation, we can say that this much distance is equal to A by E. Alright. So over here we can say that OM1 is equal to A by E. So what is this value? PS. Therefore, we can say that PS is equal to E into PM. PM means this much expression, x minus A by E. No, sorry, x1 minus A by E. Therefore, we should write x1 minus A by E. So that becomes is equal to E into x1 minus A. E into x1 minus A. So let's summarize the results so far. We got PS. So far what we have, we got this result that PS is equal to E into x1 minus A. And by similar fashion, you can also prove the other result, that the other distance PS prime, I am leaving this computation for you, that would be is equal to E into x1 plus small a. This would be the expression of PS prime. Alright, now we need to compute the coordinates of the point capital N. How to compute the coordinate of the point capital N? We shall firstly consider the equation of the tangent of the hyperbola at this point capital P. This is the equation of the hyperbola. And what would be the equation of the tangent? Just x square has to be replaced by x1. Similarly, over here, y square has to be replaced by y1. In this way, we will get the equation of the tangent at the point P. So, what would be the tangent? The tangent, equation of the tangent at the point P, this would be is equal to x1 divided by a square minus y1 divided by p square, that is equal to 1. This would be the equation of the tangent. And this tangent intersects this x-axis, And what is the equation of this x-axis? The equation of this x-axis is y is equal to 0. So in order to find the point of intersection n of the tangent and this x-axis, we shall have to put y is equal to 0. We shall have to put y is equal to 0 in this equation of the tangent. This is the equation of the tangent. So if you put y is equal to 0 over here, if we put y is equal to 0, then this second term will be vanished. And after putting y is equal to 0 over here, we shall have x1 divided by a square, that would be is equal to 1. So over here, what would be the value of x? Therefore, we can say x is equal to a square by x1. X is equal to a square by x1. Alright. So we get the coordinates of the point, x coordinate of the point capital N. X coordinate of the point capital N is equal to a square by x1. And what is the y coordinate of the point capital M? Y coordinate is equal to 0. So let's remove little bit over here. So what we get? We get that the coordinates of the point N, that would be, that these are the coordinates S square by x1, like it in this way, x1 comma 0. This would, these are the coordinates of the point N. Okay, and in that case, what is this much distance ON? That would be the x coordinate. Therefore, we can say that ON is ON is equal to this x coordinate, that is a square by x1. Therefore, what is the distance SN? What is the distance SN? SN would be equal to the total distance, this much total distance OS. SN is equal to OS minus this much distance ON. OS minus ON. Therefore, this would be is equal to OS. OS means what would be the distance OS? This OS means the x coordinate of the focus capital S. Therefore, OS should be is equal to A into E minus ON, means A square by x1. So that would be A square by x1. And this can be written as A by x1 multiplied by this can be written as A by x1 multiplied by E into x1 minus what? Minus small a. Okay, E into x1 minus small a. And what is this value? This E into x1 minus small a, this is our distance PS. Therefore, this expression can be written as A by x1 multiplied by PS. Okay. So what we got? We got the result that SN, this SN is equal to A into x1 multiplied by PS. A into x1 multiplied by PS. And similarly, we can also prove the second result, that would be is equal to, let me write it in the next page. So what we got? We got the result that SN, is equal to A by x1 into PS. Alright. By similar fashion, we can also prove the second result that S prime N is equal to A by x1 multiplied by P S prime. Alright. So from these two results, we can say that S prime N divided by SN, S prime N divided by SN, this would be is equal to P S prime divided by PS. And from this result, I discussed in the last class, from this result, we can prove that in this triangle, I am not going to deduce the total result over here. Over here, we had this kind of triangle. We had this kind of triangle, and this was the position. This was the position of S. This was S prime. This is the position of N. and this is the point P. And if this angle, suppose this angle is this one is equal to suppose theta, and this angle is equal to suppose theta prime. By taking phi, this angle is equal to phi, and in that case this angle would be is equal to phi minus phi. I proved in the last class. I'm not going to prove this one in this class over there. By this construction we can prove that sine of theta becomes is equal to sine of theta prime. And as because over here theta and theta prime altogether both are positive, along with the result that theta plus theta prime is less than the angle pi, therefore we can only from this result sine theta is equal to sine theta prime. And the only conclusion we can get over here is that theta is equal to theta prime. That means in the previous picture, this angle was equal to theta prime, and this angle was equal to theta. Therefore, theta and theta prime, these two angles would be same. Theta is equal to theta prime, is theta becomes is equal to theta prime, and in that case, if theta and theta prime are same, in that case we can say that this straight line P is prime. This would be the path of the reflection of the ray PS when it is reflected along the normal, along this normal at the point P. So this is the reflection principle in case of hyperbola. Okay. So let's start the reflection properties in case of parabola. The reflection properties. For parabola. The reflection property for parabola. Let's draw a parabola. Say this is the major axis. Major axis means the only axis. Parabola has only one axis. Say let us consider this one as x axis. And say this is the y axis. And suppose the equation of the parabola is taken as y squared is equal to 4a x. In that case, the parabola, let's extend it over here on the left. In that case, the parabola would look like this. The picture of the parabola would look like this. All right. And let us consider this this point as the focus. We know that the focus for a parabola is a comma 0, this kind of point. This is the origin or the vertex of the parabola. And suppose if you consider any point P, let us consider the coordinates of the point P. Let's write it over here. It would be easier. Let us consider the coordinates of the point P is equal to say 80 square comma twice 80. And the reflection property says that if we consider a tangent at the point P, if we consider a tangent line, let us consider a different color. A red color. If you consider a tangent line over here, so this is the tangent line, and if a mirror along this tangent, Alright, if you keep a mirror along this tangent, in that case, any ray parallel to the axis of the parabola, this kind of ray coming towards left, and in that case it would reflect along the tangent, and the property says that after reflection it will move through this focus S. Okay, after reflection it will move through this focus S. So this would be the direction of the reflected light. And over here we shall have to show that this is the direction of the reflected light, or the this line after reflection it would pass through this focus capital S. Let's make it a bit clear. After reflection it will pass through this point capital S. We shall have to prove this kind of result. And how can we prove this result? If you can show that this angle becomes is equal to this angle, in that case we can say that yes, after reflection, alright, if this angle becomes is equal to this angle, in that case we can say that yes, after reflection this reflected line will pass through this focus capital S. Now how to prove this result? Let us consider this point of intersection as equal to the point T. We shall have to find out the coordinates of the point T. How to find out the coordinates of the point T? Let us first consider this tangent line. Equation of this tangent line. How to find out the equation of this tangent line? In this equation of the parabola, y square is to be replaced by yy1, and this 4ax that would be replaced by twice a into x plus x1. This would be the equation of the tangent line. Equation of the tangent. Equation of the tangent line at the point P. So in place of x1 and y1, what is x1? x1 is equal to this x coordinate of the point P. And what is y1? y1 is equal to this y coordinate of the point P. So just put x1 is equal to 80 square and y1 is equal to twice 80 over here in this equation of the tangent. In that case, what we shall have? Y into twice a t, that is equal to twice a into x plus 80 square. So twice a get cancelled from both sides. We shall have this equation, y into t, that is equal to x plus 80 square. Now over here we shall have to compute the coordinates of the point T, and in that case we need to consider the intersection of this tangent line along this axis or the x-axis of the parabola. And what is the equation of x-axis? Equation of the x-axis is y is equal to 0. So if you put y is equal to 0 in this equation of the tangent, in that case, what we get, if we put y is equal to 0 in this equation of the tangent, in that case we shall have 0 is equal to x plus 80 square. So what is x? X becomes is equal to, x is equal to minus 80 square. So what we got? We got that equation in the coordinates of the point P. This is the x coordinate of the point of intersection T. And what is y coordinate? Y coordinate would be is equal to 0 because this point P lies on this x axis. this t lies on the x-axis, therefore the coordinates of the point t, this would be 80 square comma 0. These are the coordinates of the point t. Okay, so you see this is in the with this negative sign, it means that it is situated on the left of the origin, that's all. But what would be the distance of the point t from the origin? That would be is equal to the modulus of this 80 square. So we can say that this much distance OT, this much distance is equal to the quantity 80 square. And you see what is OS? This much distance OS is equal to OS, that is equal to A, this much distance small a. Therefore, if we add these two quantities, then what we have? We shall have ST, this much length ST, that would be is equal to A plus this much length is equal to 80 square. So we can say that A plus 80 square, that is equal to A into 1 plus t square. So we got the distance st is equal to A into 1 plus t square. So now let's make this board a bit clear. So what we finally have, we finally got this result that ST is equal to A into 1 plus T square. Now what is SP? Let us or PS, whatever you call SP or PS, let us try to find out SP square. SP square, that would be, that can be obtained by the coordinates of the point P and by the coordinates of the point S. So we can say that would be is equal to 80 square minus A, sorry, minus A whole square plus the Y coordinate is equal to twice 80. Therefore, over here we shall have twice 80 minus 0. The y coordinate of the point capital S whole square. So if we expand it all together, what we shall have? We shall have a square e to the power of 4 plus the second term would be a square minus twice a square e square plus twice 80 whole square, that means 4 a square t square. So this is equal to a square e to the power of 4 plus 2 a square t square plus a square. So if we take this a square common, then after taking common you shall have t to the power of 4 plus 2 t square plus 1, and that would be is equal to 1 plus t square whole square, 1 plus t square whole square. Okay, and you see 1 plus t square whole square, so this is equal, this is our distance st, therefore this would be is equal to st square. So SP square is equal to ST square. So from this result, we can say that SP, as because both of them are non-negative, therefore we can say that SP is equal to ST. SP is equal to ST. That means you see, that means this distance, and this distance, SP and ST. In this triangle, let me write this triangle in a fresh way. You see, we have a triangle like this. We have a triangle like this, and this is the point T, this is S, and this is the point P. And what we have proved? We have proved that SP is equal to ST. SP is equal to ST. That means these two sides, this side and this side, these two sides are equal. And as because these two sides are equal, therefore this angle must be equal to this angle. And what was the previous picture? Let me draw this over here. So this angle, this angle, so let us call it theta. This angle must be equal to this angle, and this theta must be equal to this angle theta. So what we got, we find that this angle theta becomes is equal to this angle. And therefore we can say that yes, this ray, if it comes towards the point P parallel to this axis, in that case, after reflection, it must pass through this point capital S. And this is actually the basic idea behind the formulation of any kind of dish. In case of transmission, we generally use different kind of dish antenna. And this is the basic idea of making this kind of dish antenna, that any signal, the signals should come parallel to this x-axis, and the receiver is generally situated at this focus S. That's why if any signal, parallel signals come and reflects on this surface, which is actually a paraboloid in three-dimensional geometry, or a parabola in two-dimensional geometry. So after reflection, it would come to the receiver situated at this focus. So due to this kind of reflection property, we are able to make this kind of dish antenna. So this is the reflection property of the parabola.
So that's all for this lecture. Thank you for being with us.